They fled in that direction. I should be able to find a way in. I already passed by the Église Sainte-Marie. I can get back there quickly from here. Barrels were stored here and rolled away. These grooves prove it. It would appear that Monsieur Lavoisier's gunpowder was taken to the Bastille.
It's going to be all right. This machine is a lug and the door is barricaded.
Worshippers were able to escape the automats. They ran towards the entrance to the catacombs. So Madame Necker escaped. I must inform her husband immediately.
Thank you.
Not a single one escaped.
Thank you.
Monsieur Necker.
Madame? Eh bien, do you come bearing good news?
Your wife. You may rest easy, monsieur. Your wife escaped the massacre. She returned home and left you this letter.
Mon Dieu. She's going to meet our daughter and son-in-law at our charity hospital.
She may already be there.
Madame, I did not dare to dream of such an outcome. My wife and daughter. Can you imagine? And I thought I had lost both of them. The three of us will be able to leave the kingdom and put these horrors behind us forever.
What about the bonds?
They're not in your possession.
No, not yet.
You must ensure they do not benefit the king, madame. You will find them in the Armoire de Fer, in the Palais des Tuileries. Do with them as you see fit. As long as the king does not use them. As for me, I'm going to find my family at once. Thank you. From the bottom of my heart, I pray that your efforts will be successful. Adieu, madame. Adieu.
Minister Necker has given his bonds to me.
That's quite a nice little sum. Can you imagine? That's one-fifth of the kingdom's entire wealth.
Wealth that the king squanders for his personal benefit according to his whims.
Ma foi. Monsieur Necker certainly has been very generous to his adoptive country.
Generous? I have my doubts. The loan was granted at a very high rate. So high, in fact, that it would have dug the deficit into an even deeper state of abyss.
Eh bien, monsieur. To what use shall we employ this boonful fortune?
If I could spend it, I'd do everything I could to return to the people their confiscated freedom. To begin, I would get them the bread they so sorely need. It is only after the scourge of famine has been vanquished that armed patriots might then be able to rise up against despotism.
And where will you find wheat, Robespierre? Will you steal it from under the noses of the automats who have sworn to destroy the human race? As for arming the people, this is another one of your delusions. How could your ragged pack of wretches win any sort of battle that'd be unable to lift a sword?
When you insult the people, you insult me, Monsieur de Lafayette.
I am not insulting anyone, Robespierre. But I happen to know what it takes to fight, unlike you. Monsieur, I was but a lad of 15 when I took up arms. And everyone here knows my role in the liberation of America from British rule. If you allow me to dispose of these bonds, I will found an army that will annihilate the Clockwork King's diabolical machines. As soon as I have the opportunity to leave Paris, I will rally the officers and troops that are stationed in the provinces. Then, I will call for a mass uprising. I will have more than enough money to pay their wages and procure the weapons we need.
And you will have obedient troops at your beck and call, ready to repress anyone who challenges your power.
These troops will only serve the will of the people. I swear it.
Are you sure that the king has spared the rest of the kingdom, Monsieur le Marquis?
I am almost certain of it, mon père. Despite all of his resources, the king does not have enough manpower to occupy all the garrisons in the country.
Aegis, no member of this assembly can force your hand. The choice is yours. To whom will you entrust Monsieur Necker's bonds?
The bonds are not yet in my possession.
Then please continue your search.
Thank you.
Here I am at an impasse. Should I go to the Tuileries to examine the safe? There may be a way to force it open. I can get to the Tuileries Palace via the Louvre. Then I should be able to enter it through the courtyard. The lock wasn't forced. Whoever opened it had the key. Monsieur Necker's bonds are still there. Something engraved on it. H.G. Ricchetti. Comte de Mirabeau. Whoever broke into this safe left behind the most valuable thing in it. This doesn't make sense.
I can't anymore!
Chin up, old man. Bite down on this strip of leather. I'm going to take a closer look at your wound. Oh, it's more serious than I thought. Look at me. You have to hang in there, all right? You mustn't fall asleep.
Vincent. No. I'm losing him.
Is there any way I can help you?
Send you an automat.
What can I expect from you, other than the cruel fate that your fellow monsters reserve for patriots?
Monsieur, I am not anything like them.
Honestly, I don't have much of a choice. I have to take you at your word and ask for your help. I have with me a fighter who has lost his leg. He's already lost a lot of blood. If I don't operate within the hour, I doubt he will survive. Unfortunately, I do not have any surgical tools with me. Would you be so kind as to find me something I can use to save this brave man?
Here, monsieur. I hope this will be suitable.
Parbleu. You're an angel here on Earth. I will make sure that this poor man knows to whom he owes his life. Leave me now. I must be alone to carry out this delicate operation.
I have just come from the Tuileries. The Armoire de Fer has been ransacked.
Diable! Someone beat us to it. This is very unfortunate. God only knows what we would have found there.
Whoever it was had to fight for it. I found a body there, killed by automats.
Mon Dieu. How dreadful.
Dreadful indeed. Especially since I discovered this in the victim's hand.
And what is that, pray tell?
A dueling pistol, with your name engraved on its plate.
Oh, I... May we? You're right. It is my pistol. It was stolen along with a number of other things. It happened just before the Estates General at my lodgings in Versailles. But how on earth did my weapon end up in the hands of this poor soul?
I am certain we will find an explanation. I'm going to have a look around. With your permission, of course.
Well, since I'm in no position to dissuade you.
You appear to have burnt these papers in a hurry. I'm eager to hear your explanation.
It's nothing at all, I assure you. Frivolous letters that were cluttering my desk.
I find your defense unconvincing. Why won't you tell me the truth?
You don't understand. This is a matter of the utmost importance that I cannot discuss with a creature such as yourself.
I am an automat, monsieur. This is true, but I serve the Queen, and my only aim is to put a stop to the crimes that have befallen the kingdom.
Well, know that you're not alone in serving the Queen.
What was in those letters you threw into the fire?
My private correspondence with the King. I had a key to the armoire, which served as a mailbox.
Are you conspiring with the King?
No, you don't understand. I was something of a shadow advisor, a diplomat, working in complete discretion. I feared his stubbornness would lead the kingdom to ruin, so I tried to reassure him regarding the aims of the Third Estate. But when Vaucanson told me what happened at Meudon, I realized it was a lost cause.
You claim to be a friend of the Queen.
The King has gone insane. After what happened at Meudon, that much is clear. We can no longer expect any leniency from him. Hence my support for his wife. She's a headstrong woman, and much wiser than she lets on. You must know that she means to put her youngest on the throne, the young prince, Louis Charles. A regency would restore peace and unity to the kingdom. Then all that would remain would be to establish a constitution. I have the support of the people. They trust me. I'm the only one that can bring about these reforms.
I found your pistol in the hands of a dead man. Who was this unfortunate soul?
Mathieu, one of the servants I had sent to retrieve the letters. I gave him the pistol for self-defense. Alas, it seems it was of little use to him against the King's automats.
Tell me, what happened at Meudon?
It's all here in this letter, written in the King's own hand. Please, give it to the Queen. She must learn the truth.
Why were you in such a hurry to destroy your correspondence?
The letters contained sensitive information about my Third Estate colleagues. If it had gotten out, I would have surely lost my allies' trust. As well as any hope of establishing a regency along with it.
Monsieur le Marquis.
I'm listening, Aegis.
The bonds are in my possession.
And to whom do you intend to give them?
I have decided to use these bonds to support your cause. I implore you to put them to good use.
I swear it to you. You made the right choice, Dancer. Only professional soldiers and well-trained conscripts stand a chance of winning back the kingdom.